We will now enter one of the houses in Pompeii, before the volcanic outbreak 2,000 years ago. It is the house of Caecilius Jucundus, one of the rich men of Pompeii. In the morning, the big entrance room must have contained many dependent people coming around to salute the owner, and probably also Jucundus' business companions from Rome and Pompeii. In the afternoon, the room must have changed character, with weaving women and a lot of household work going on. The light conditions changed throughout the day, the daylight flowing in from the upper part of the room together with rainwater that was collected here, and in the night, only oil lamps. This is Jucundus himself, and this is his money chest. He was certainly a rich man, although he didn't belong to the uppermost elite of the town. We know from his business correspondence that he belonged to the level just below the richest and the political elite in Pompeii. This is the house altar, very lavishly decorated and reminiscent of an earthquake 17 years before the big volcanic eruption, year 79 AD. Look at the cleverly built light intake here. This is what allowed people to work here during daytime. This is the working room of the family father. It is called the tabularium, and this is why we placed a table here to mark the case. It is the most beautifully decorated room in the house to mark the status of the owner. When we return to the paintings as they are today, you can see that the big mythological paintings have been removed to museums. And this is also true in the banquet hall, somewhat further inside the house. This is where Jucundus received his guests in the evenings. There were a restricted number of guests in this room and in Roman banquets in general, less than 10 persons. In the garden rooms, Jucundus could relax in the afternoon in nice conditions with a view of the play fountain in the garden. We must believe that there were slaves everywhere, and lots of house people, for this was not a house for one family, but a house for a big extended one.